Hello, everybody, and welcome to 2021 CPAC here in Dallas. I am Alex Caldwell here with Ellie Koheinem. And Ellie, would you tell me a little bit about what you do here?
Sure, Alex. So I was honored and privileged to serve in the Trump administration as the Deputy Envoy to Combat Antisemitism. And in the Trump administration, our policy was crystal clear. We understood that anti-Zionism is anti-Semitism, and so much of the hatred of Jews today is coming through the hatred of the Jewish state of Israel. And President Trump will truly go down in history as the most philo-Semitic president in the history of the United States and the best friend of the Jewish state of Israel that Israel has ever had.
One of the things that President Trump did was he moved the embassy, the United States embassy, into Jerusalem in Israel. So I was wondering, what do you think about that?
Well, you know, President Trump kept his promises. So, candidate after candidate during elections would promise to move America's embassy to Jerusalem. And President Trump kept his promise, along with all the other promises. It was a historic move. And the reason why is that Jerusalem is the eternal capital of the Jewish people. And the American embassy belongs in Israel, in Jerusalem. And after the U.S. made this historic move, Guatemala followed soon after. And most recently, we saw Honduras make the same move. And it's really an important piece in understanding Middle East relations, because when the United States acknowledges Israel's right to her historic capital of Jerusalem and acknowledges the historic Jewish presence in Israel, it fosters peace. And so that was the peace that we saw with the Abraham Accords, with the United Arab Emirates, Bahrain, and then Morocco and Sudan making these warm peace deals with Israel that President Trump, Jared Kushner, and the team negotiated the first peace in 26 years in the region.
So Trump had a really big role with Israel relations and the Jewish people. And I'm wondering, what do you think about the way that Biden has handled it since Trump has left office?
You know, Alex, the Trump administration left the Middle East with, like I said, four peace deals, but also we left the Iranian regime in a very difficult spot. We levied the maximum pressure campaign on the Iranians, which left them, according to the IMF, with only $4 billion in accessible foreign currency reserves. So the Iranians are weak, and they have been contained. And so this is the Middle East that we handed to the Biden administration on a silver platter with peace deals and a weak Iran. Well, almost immediately, we saw the Biden administration completely turn over everything that was accomplished. So they have given up all the leverage that we gained with the Iranians with the maximum pressure campaign. And they have also created an atmosphere that eventually led to Hamas attacking Israel with 4,000 rockets, raining down on Israeli population centers and civilians.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm also curious about what you think with the Israel and Palestinian relations that are going on right now, where we see on the news a lot, we see that there's a lot of fighting and a lot of turmoil, and we see the Palestinians a lot of times firing on the Israelis. I'm wondering, what do you think about that?
Alex, you know, the biggest challenge, I would say, with the Palestinian population is their leadership. Their leadership has failed them. Their leadership is corrupt. And so this is a real problem for the Palestinian people, because they eventually are the ones who suffer as a result. What happened in the Trump administration is that we were willing to look at the Middle East with a fresh perspective. Mm-hmm. So administration after administration before us had tried to create peace by kind of giving in to every Palestinian demand. And the Trump administration understood that we were not going to allow the Palestinians to have this veto over peace in the Middle East. And so again, we were able to achieve peace. There was also the peace to prosperity plan that was offered to the Palestinians, which would have brought in billions and billions of dollars into the Palestinian areas. They rejected it. They rejected the Trump peace plan, and then they cut off relations with the United States of America. So I would say that the Palestinian people deserve better leadership. They deserve a leadership that will allow them to achieve everything that they can and to live in peace side by side by the Jewish state of Israel.
A lot of people in Congress have come out against Israel, people such as Rashida Tlaib, Congresswoman Rashida Tlaib from Michigan, or Minnesota Congresswoman Ilhan Omar, and they have spoken out in favor of Palestine. And I'm wondering, what do you think about the rhetoric of Tlaib and Omar? Do you think that that is a negative thing?
Alex, I'm so glad that you're raising this issue. In fact, it is not just negative what Ilhan Omar, Rashida Tlaib, AOC, Bernie Sanders, and Elizabeth Warren do. What they're kind of engaging in a modern day blood libel where they accuse the Jewish state of Israel of apartheid, no matter what the facts are. These are just flat out lies. And they accuse Israel of committing genocide. So when they do that, they legitimize Jew hatred. And for the first time, Alex, we witnessed something in the United States of America that we've never experienced before. Mm-hmm. And that is that when there was this conflict in Israel with Hamas, at the same time, we start to see Jews on the streets of America being attacked by Palestinian flag waving mobs who drove through Jewish neighborhoods in Los Angeles and New York and other parts of the country. And they got out of that car, they were looking for Jews, and they assaulted, physically assaulted Jews and left them in the hospital. We've never had that in America before. It's completely un-American. And when I look at the facts and I say, if something new is happening that's never happened before, well, what else is new? And what else is new is, again, Ilhan Omar, Rashida Tlaib, AOC, the Squad, Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren, all these people engaging in modern day blood libel against the Jews, and therefore you find Jews getting assaulted and hurt on the streets. And I have to tell you something, it's time for all good people to push back against them. Ilhan Omar does not belong on the Foreign Relations Committee. And it's really time for the Democratic Party leadership to step up to the plate and fight anti-Semitism when they have it amongst their own ranks.
Well, Ellie, I want to thank you for coming on today. I enjoyed getting to speak with you.
Thank you.
This is Ellie Koheinem. Thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Alex.
Thank you.